time, lagi ka na lang nagino. For a very long time, lagi na lang akong tumatakas sa mga responsibilities or mga duties ng isang Christian. I was saved long time, I was saved 1995, very long time. But I grew up sa isang Christian church, I grew up sa isang Christian family. Pero ang Panginoon is talagang very faithful sa akin, pero ako never ang naging faithful sa akin. Pag ginawa ko is tumakas ng tumakas sa kanya, hanggang sa narating ako ng kanya. Pero never ako naging loob sa any service tungkol sa Panginoon. But I think God, I thank God because He's very gracious to me, because He allowed me to serve Him. He allowed me to join the Bible studies, even though that everyone is aware that I'm just new in BBC. I'm just almost around 5 to 6 months old na kilala ko kayo, we joined the group. But I felt like deep down inside my heart, I felt like I'm with you for quite some time, for a long time, for a minute. And I'm very thankful for Pastor John for giving me this opportunity, most especially to our Heavenly Father, to Jesus Christ. Because without this opportunity, I will not be able to serve Him. So, God is really very good to all of us. So, for this afternoon, I would like to ask you to open your Bibles to Isaiah 40, 30 to 31. Say amen if you are there already.
Amen.
Isaiah 40, 30 to 31. Let's read it all together. 30, even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly flow. Upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Let's all pray. Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for this opportunity once again to study your word and listen to your word. Please, Lord, give me a discernment so that I will be able to impart to the listeners what are the messages that you want for them to learn today. Lord, give me the wisdom and the knowledge, and hide me behind your back so that may I glorify you, may we glorify you, not the one that are speaking in front of them. But for also our other listeners, I would like to pray to you, Father, that may you open their hearts and their minds, convict their hearts, and speak to their minds, my Lord, that may they be able to understand and may they be able to quote the message that you have in store or you have prepared for them today, this afternoon. All these things we pray in Christ's precious name. Amen.
Amen.
As I continue with our message, is actually, I would like to ask an apology to everyone because I am actually very nervous right now. Sister Precious was saying that is there any ambulance near us? I'm worried that this is a big thing. I'm worried because I'm too heavy. Maybe not if you can get me. So, I'm very blessed because God gave me a wife who is a nurse also, my profession. Because so that she may be able to learn how to be stronger, to carry me when I stood in front of the brethren, when I painted, she can give me the first aid. So, and the second thing, I was blessed because the last time that I felt nervous, and actually I told Pastor about this one, this is my worst, this is my weakness. I have a stage fright since I was a child. Until now, I'm really happy to be able to speak in a crowd or anything. So, I know that God will give me strength. I'm always saying to my behind my head right now, but Philippians 4:16, that God will strengthen me. And I can do all things through Christ. Hallelujah. So, for this afternoon, the message that I have prepared for you today is, what does waiting accomplish in a life of a believer? And I know that Pastor John had made some small revisions in the message. I think he changed the topic to waiting on the Lord. And then, which is, I know that Pastor John knows better than I do, so I go with Pastor John. So, waiting on the Lord. What does waiting upon the Lord accomplish in a life of a believer? This is a big question mark for each and everyone. So, this morning, we have heard the message of Pastor John concerning how do we prepare for the Lord's coming. Amen?
Amen.
So, if you're going to ask each and everyone right now, how do we prepare for the coming of the Lord? Pastor John had explained just a while ago what are the things that we need to do in order to prepare. But for this afternoon, I will empower you again. I will add more things on this concerning waiting upon the Lord, but this message that I will be imparting to you, this message is about waiting upon the Lord for through your prayers that you have, through the heart's desires that you have in your heart. Is there anyone right now who is desiring or praying for someone, and there are somebody, for example, there are somebody who have lost their job? I know deep down their heart they're praying that, Lord, give me another job.
Amen.
There are some brethren who are praying for child. Who are praying for a long time, maybe they don't have a child. They're praying that, Lord, when are you going to give us a child? Some brethren who are having illnesses on their lives, who are having relatives that are ill. I know for sure that each and every one of us right now, they are praying that may their relatives will be healed. They are praying for God to help them in their condition right now. So I don't know what are the things that you have right now in your heart, but this afternoon we'll be discussing some few things in order for us to realize that how God is good to our life and how He's working in our lives. Amen. So I just wanted you to share. I will not ask you to open your Bibles, but if I will discuss with you in the book of Genesis, everybody is aware and everybody knew who is Abraham, right? Abraham is Abraham, but he was God promised Abraham to become a father of all nations. But the problem is, how can he become a father of all nations wherein his wife Sarah is a barren? Amen. Do you think if ever God will talk to you right now and God will promise you something, and you know deep down your physical condition, if it's not possible, if you really think it's going to, there's a reality, it's going to be kind of impossible. But for with God, nothing is impossible.
Amen.
It took 25 years around of waiting in order for Abraham and Sarah to be able to bear a child. Amen?
Amen.
It took them these 20 years in order for them to believe, in order for them to realize that God is really true to His promises. Amen?
Amen.
Even to our lives, God is really true to His promises. So, if you don't think about ourselves, what is going to happen to us if we need to wait for 25 years? Because 25 years is a very long time. When all hope is already gone, sumuko na tayo na. Pero that's the time that God gave Sarah a child. Amen?
Amen?
So, we can use this as an example. In the case of David, it took him how many years to run away from Saul? He's running and hiding because King Saul is looking for him. He wants to kill David. Amen? So, do you think David prayed to God? Why is it that I spent how many years hiding for Saul when he knows deep down inside that God promised him to be the king of Israel? If he is going to be the next king, why he needs to wait? Why he needs to wait for a very long time? In our lives as a believer, do we have something in our hearts that we are praying that we think becomes going to be possible because God is really not answering our prayers? Amen? Sometimes it is worrying us down. It is burning us down. Parang sisira, parang puti-puti tayo ng puso. Parang walang nangyayari sa mga panalangin natin sa Lord. But God is faithful to our lives. Amen?
Amen.
If we are going to open Mark 14:36. Please open your Bibles to Mark 14:36. I'll discuss the first point. This will be very quick. Say amen if you are there. Mark 14:36. And he said, Abba, Father, all things are possible unto thee. Take away this cup from me. Nevertheless, not that I will, but what thou wilt. The one who is speaking right now is on this passage was Jesus Christ. He was praying to the Lord to remove his cup. The meaning of the cup was, this is the future sufferings and the future death that Jesus Christ will suffer in the cross. Amen? But if you will check the verses and how does God say it, nevertheless, not that what I will, but what thou wilt. Jesus is saying to the Father, ikaw na po ang bahala, Panginoon. Kayo po ang masusunod. Ako po ay mag-under ng authority. Jesus Christ is God. Siya po isang pang-Diyos. Pero mayroon pong mas mataas sa Kanya, which is, He is under, at under lang po siya because there is a God of the Father. Amen? So, on this verse, saying he's willing to succumb to the authority or to the will of the Lord. In our lives, all about our lives, if we pray for something, if we pray, Lord, I'm praying for new car, but sometimes God will grant us a car, but it is a second-hand car. Do we believe? Sometimes, I don't know what is in our hearts, but as a human nature, as a fallen creature before we are not saved, we tend to complain, because that's our nature. But we should be reminded that God, our Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus Christ, supported His life or listened to the will of the Father. Amen?
Amen.
I will give you another example through this. If you open your Bibles to 2 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians chapter 12, you will just see from this passage that I will just tell it to us, that you can see from this that the case for this one is that Apostle Paul has a thorn in the flesh. Amen?
Amen.
He is suffering a thorn in the flesh. I don't know what is thorn in the flesh, but I know he is sick, he is badly ill, and he is suffering, and he knows that if this thorn in the flesh will continue to remain in his life, this will cause him to, or this will hinder his service to the Lord. But he prayed to the Lord 3 times that the Lord Jesus Christ will remove his sickness. What does do you think, brother and bottom? God, Jesus Christ, didn't remove this thorn in the flesh. But Jesus Christ only said that my grace is sufficient for you. If we will know, Apostle Paul was a apostle. He is a they are the giants in faith. Amen. Sila po ang mga faithful na tao, faithful na nagsisilbi sa ating Panginoon. They almost, as Pastor said, that they almost turn the world upside down. But they can make the lame walk, they can make the blind see, they can do everything in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But do you think Apostle Paul think deep down himself, or did he ask himself that if I can do all the impossible things, why can't I can't cure myself? Amen? Did you face this kind of struggle in your life? Everybody does, I think so. Whether you admit it or not, I know deep down in our hearts, we have some thoughts that are entertaining in our hearts because Satan is inculcating to our mind that we should feel this way. We should feel this way. Like what Pastor John said just a while ago, that we should guard our eyes, we should guard our hearts, we should guard our ears, our mouth, or our minds, especially our minds, because maybe we may be able to be entertaining some evil thoughts deep down in our minds. Amen?
Amen?
So, on the first point, waiting on the Lord teaches us to submit to His will. We should submit ourselves to the will of the Father. Instead of praying, Lord, grant me this, I want this, I need this, ask yourself, is this really what God wants for us? You think, Lord, I don't deserve this. No, I think so, that is what deserve for you, or what is that? That is the best one for you, because that is what God wants you to have. So sometimes we are always thinking about ourselves. Sometimes we become selfish. So through this verse, we should always be reminded that if our Heavenly Father Jesus Christ succumbed His will to the will of the Father, we should also do this. While we are waiting for our Lord Jesus Christ to come for the second coming, while we are waiting for the answers to our prayers, we should, and we, God will enable us to submit to His will. If we will only have the desires. Sometimes the problem in our lives is we are saying it with our mouth, but we don't really mean it by through our hearts. It's easy to say that I want to serve God. But the reality, we are not willing to give up our time, our efforts, our money, and everything. But through this, we should bear in mind that we should submit to our Heavenly Father will. When we pray, we should tell ourselves, Lord, Thy will be done. This is Your will for me, then so be it. I will just follow Your will. Also mentioned in Romans 12:22 that be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. we should always remember that all the things that we are doing, we should always, or all our things that we are praying for the Lord, we should think first before we ask from the Lord. Instead of saying, Lord, I need it, ask the Lord, Lord, is this your will for me? Then we do that. Actually, this word, this submission is very difficult, actually. And this is really very difficult, because even saying like submitting yourselves to, I mean, some, our wives, it's very difficult to submit themselves to their husbands. But we should submit, amen?
Yeah.
So, kung hindi yung kapatihan dyan yung mababa, but, alam niya ni Sister Lai, alam niya, she should submit. That's why the first thing. Amen? So my second point this afternoon is that waiting on the Lord, the first point is waiting on the Lord teaches us submission to His will. Waiting on the Lord teaches us to submit to His will. Amen? The second point, if waiting on the Lord, it produces a sincere prayer. When we are waiting for something for the Lord, what do? We pray. Amen? We pray. When we need something to the Lord, we pray. When we are praying for something, we pray. When we need something, what we do? We pray. Because this is the only thing that, how can we communicate to our Lord Jesus Christ? Amen? Even though when we ask forgiveness for our sins, we can only do this by praying. Amen? So if you are waiting on something for the Lord, we can, our prayer life will be totally, completely had some makeover. If sister said one time nung umuwi sila ng bakasyon is pag-uwi niya, na-surprise sila kasi ang ganda na ng bahay niya. Like, sabi mo kasi, nakaka-amaze. Pag na-amaze sa isang bagay is parang ang ganda. Di ba? Tama? So this is the same for us. If we need something to the Lord, kung nagpipray ka lang isang beses, pagkagising mo, normally dahil may kailangan sa Panginoon, gagawin mo, parati ka nagpipray. Amen? Sinasabi yan sa, it is said that our everyday needs, we should not worry about our everyday needs. Amen? And everything must be done through prayer. It's up to 1 Thessalonians 5:17 that we should pray without ceasing. Kailangan magdasal tayo ng magdasal hanggang sa walang tingin tayo magdasal. We should not stop praying. Everything should be done by Philippians. If you're going to open your Bible to Philippians 4:16, I'll just read it for you. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Be careful for nothing. We should not worry about what are we going to eat later on. We should not worry about... this is how God is so good to our lives. In BBC. Maybe every other day, may kainan. Kaya wala ata akong nakita sa BBC na lumiliit. And if you pray mo sa Panginoon na magbawas kasi nilalaro ako basketball. Pero parang mas lalong... Amen? Kasi magaling pa kayong pagkain. There are a lot of food. And for example, there is a, this work case. Tomorrow, there will be a baby shower again for... It's amazing. Ina-announce ko na sa inyo kasi... Amen? So what I'm trying to say is, in our lives, we should be careful for nothing. We should not worry about anything. Okay? But the Lord will supply everything for us. But in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. Amen? So lahat ng pangangailangan natin, kailangan natin magdasal sa Panginoon.
Amen?
Amen? Kaya lang, pag mayroon tayong problema, normally daw ang isang mayroon pag may pinag-pray sa Panginoon, pag-pray siya na tayo na for na higa. Lord, thank you sa gabi ko, salamat sa araw na ito. Amen. Pero pag once you are a believer and you are praying for something in your life, you're praying for a life partner, like Brother Bernard. I'm sure,
brother, amen.
Is really thriving. He is really on this list for sure. Kasi time is running out and he should do this. Kasi sometimes sa ating Panginoon, kailangan natin kailangan natin tumaba tayo sa pagdarap sa Panginoon. Amen! Gawin natin para bigyan ang kasagutan yung ating mga panalangin.
Amen!
So, brother, ginawa ko.
Richard!
Kung hindi ako pinapapasok, this is a bad omen. Trying to say, brother, is that pray when we have something in our lives, this really drives us to pray. Amen? So, I will give you an example. How does, in the Bible, there are a lot of Bible characters who really pray so much in order to get their desires or their answers to their prayer. But I will just give you an example right now because we will finish the Bible club if I will tell you everyone. But I will tell you on 1 Samuel chapter 1, Hannah, on this passage, on that day before you, but I'll just explain it to you. Hannah is a barren woman. Amen? Hannah is a barren. But for the case of Hannah, she was the great example of how if you pray for something and you badly and you really drive to your knees, you cry to the Lord, you shout to the Lord what is really deep down inside your heart. This is really Hannah's example of when you pray so much to the Lord. Sabi nga niya sa kapatid, pag kinalang pa kumalangin, talagang hindi ka tumigil na pray. The problem is Hannah, she is a barren. But she did not stop pleading to the Lord. But the Lord granted her request. The Lord gave her something. And Hannah tell the Lord that once God will grant her request, she will offer first time to serve him through his lifeline. Amen? So, in our case, is there anyone right now who is an example who prays like same life as Hannah prayed? Sabi nga na diba, sabi daw si Hannah, parang na siya kasi kung nag-pray siya, parang giniparable si Lord towards niya. Sobrang, parang hain-hain na siya. Sobrang pag-pray niya sa Panginoon. Amen? Buhang sa mundo, nahahay tayo sa mga ibang bagay. Mas magandang mahay tayo sa Panginoon.
Amen.
Kasi we will be high sa Holy Spirit. We will be full of the Holy Spirit. Mas maganda po yun. Amen? Amen. So, sino po sa inyo ngayon kapag na to? Ang mayroong attitude na patulad kay Hannah. Whom she knows that she need badly an answer from the Lord. And she will not stop. She will plead from the Lord to pray for something that she badly, you know, that the Lord, she claimed that she already knew that God will answer her request. Even though that she's a barren, but the Lord opened her womb. Amen? At nag-umulungis po siya at nagkaroon siya ng anak. Kung wala po siguro yun, wala tayo ang hukong Samuel. Amen? So first point is we should learn, waiting upon the Lord, we should learn how to submit to the will of the Lord. Second, waiting upon the Lord, it produces a sincere prayer life. Third, waiting on the Lord teaches us to trust in the Lord with all our hearts. Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, lean not unto thy own understanding. Ito ang mahirap sa lahat. We are saying by our mouth that we do trust the Lord, but the reality, we are still going back to our instinct, our human nature, to do our own part. That we think that if we pray, Lord, give me this heart. But nothing is happening, then I will do my will. Amen? So, if you will, we know that Abraham really trusted the Lord. Amen? But if you will not fully trust the Lord, when the Lord promised him to be the father of all nations, and of course, Sarah will be the mother, He listened to Sarah to try to go to Hagar. Amen? So once we didn't trust the Lord fully by our heart, there will be some implications, there will be some consequences on our lives. So we need to trust the Lord fully with all our hearts. We have only one heart, but we have to give it all. Like you said, Pastor, we have to trust Him with all our hearts. Amen? In Philippians 4:11, when we do not understand our problem seems to get the best of us, we need to remember that God is always and still in control. Amen? Sabi ni Paul, for I have learned God's providence comes in reality of our lives. It's in Philippians 4:11. Sabi ni Apostle Paul, for I have learned trusting the Lord, it will not come up as a magic. It will come through a process. If you really love the Lord, of course you will trust the Lord. Amen? So, on the next example that I will give you, this is Mark 27, sinasabi dito, God, there's nothing impossible sa ating Panginoon. I will give you an example of how, first, one example like Job 13:18, sinasabi ni Job, though he slay me, yet I will trust in him, but I will maintain my own ways before him. Ganun po ba tayo sa Panginoon? Are we like that in the Lord? We trust our God with all our hearts. We don't even care about our lives, but we know that even if it will take our life, God has a purpose for that. I will tell you one illustration. How is really, bakit napaganda ng tao may tuwala sa Panginoon? Open your Bibles to Jeremiah 17:7-8. Let's read it all together. Jeremiah 17:7-8. Jeremiah 17:7-8.
Amen.
Let's all read. Blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is. For he shall be as a tree planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out her roots by the river, and shall not see when heat cometh, but her leaf shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought, neither shall cease from heat. Kung makikita po natin, we will see from this passage from Jeremiah that blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord. And whose hope the Lord is. For he will be, if you are a person who trusts the Lord with all your heart, you will be compared or you will be illustrated as a tree planted beyond the river banks. If you will see, you will compare the tree that is planted here in Qatar. You will see that they need somebody to be employed to water the plants. But in our country, the Philippines, you will see that there are some trees planted on the river bank or along the river. You will see the roots. If you will compare the tree of the one planted in the river is very big and the leaves are very big. We need to say it is very strong. It's because the water is just behind him or behind the tree. He can easily absorb the water. It will be the nourishment to the tree and it will not cease yielding fruit. As a believer, kung tayo ay isang mananampalataya, if you are a believer that is planted by a river banks or by the waters, maybe the waters will be compared as in the living or reading the word of God all the time. You are living a godly life. You will not cease yielding fruit. Kahit anong kung gawin natin, in everything that we do, we will always produce or we will always bear fruit. Amen? So, if I will ask you right now, which one will you choose? Do you want to be a tree that is planted on the desert, or you want to be a tree that is planted by the waters? So this question will remain to our hearts. Maybe you have to think that if you are a tree that is planted near the waters, you will not have any lacking or you will not have any deficiency in your life. All the things that you need, the food, all the blessings, all and everything will be with you. Because you are planted on the river. And the tree needs water. Same for the human being, same for us. We don't need only food. We need the word of God in order for us to grow and in order for us to live. So the Bible is really very important for us. We have to trust God with all our hearts, with all our minds. We should not trust our own self. Because we will always be deceived by our hearts and by our life. Sa ating sarili. Amen? So, last point is that waiting on the Lord renews our strength spiritually. We will see it. This is our key verse, Isaiah 40:31. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk. On this passage, we will see that the Lord is promising to every believer who wants to wait for the Lord, renewal of their strength. Renewal of the strength, not just only physical strength, but spiritual strength. Because if we are renewed spiritually, we will be stronger than the one that is not nourished spiritually. Amen? So, kung makikita nyo, if you have problems, it will be easily seen in your life. It will be easily seen in your eyes. people will know if you are happy or you are not happy. Through your eyes, through our eyes, it reflects our personality, our, what do we have right now? Ano ba ang sitwasyon, ano ba ang estado tayo sa buhay natin? Makikita mo ang tao malungkot sa pamamagitan ng kanyang mga. Kaya makikita mo si Brad Burnett, lagi kong lumulit ko dito pa. Say, inspired siya. Sinasabi ng Panginoon, the kings of women wait for the Lord.
Speak on.
We will wait for the Lord. God promises to renew our strength. And they shall mount up with wings as eagles. It will be, God will help us once we encounter some problems in our life. We know that we are heavenly beings already. The moment that we accept the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior, hindi na po tayo mga taga-lupa. Galing po tayo sa langit. At doon po tayo papunta pagkatapos natin. So, God will mount us with the wings of an eagle. We will soar above our problems. If we will wait upon the Lord, He will renew our strength. Yung mga problema po natin is talaga, makikita niyo na po na nasa baba natin. Hindi po tayo ma-overcome ng problema natin because we will overcome our problems. Second, they shall run and not be weary. Sa pamamagitan ng ating pagtatakbo o pag-serve sa Panginoon, hindi tayo mapapagod. Because God will empower us, God will renew our strength every time. Kasi we are doing this for the Lord. He will never give us anything na alam na hindi natin. Amen. Third, lastly, they shall walk and not faint. Whatever we have, this is representing our Christian way of life. Who are walking by our Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus Christ. God will help us not to faint. Hindi po tayo magmahihimatay. Hindi po tayo mag-stop. Kasi all the problems that we will be encountering in our lives, if we are walking by faith, if we are walking by the Lord, He will help us not to faint. Amen? So, lahat ng bagay na ma-encounter natin is starting po yan sa if we need something from the Lord, if we pray something for the Lord, God will teach us while we are waiting for the Lord. God will teach us to be submissive with me. Second, God will teach us how to become or how to have a sincere prayer life. Third, God will teach us that to trust in the Lord with all our hearts. And lastly, waiting on the Lord renews our strength spiritually. So, as I close, brother, right now, I have no idea what are the cases that you are facing right now in your life. I don't know what is the situation that you are facing right now. I don't know if you are completely, everything is with you. I don't know if you are, everything is complete in your life. But the moment that we accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, we are a heavenly being. We have a Father in heaven that will supply all our needs. He will never leave us. Whatever situation you have right now in your life, maybe you have a job situation that is leading you very tough. Hindi na kung mga kapag, hindi na kung mga kasama mo sa opisina. You are praying for something that God will answer, or God will change the situation that you have in your office, in your work, in your job site. Parang work, parang araw-araw na naman. In my case, I'm facing in my office, I have three Indians in our office. Now they put some three guys in our office. So you have to adjust with a lot of things. You have to adjust with everything. But we praise God because God is really good. He really teaches us something. I know God has a purpose why He said, the reason why I share with you this message is because He's really protects me. He's really teaches me a lot of things, even until now. I'm really struggling with this, but I know that through this, it will be a great blessing if I will be able to share it with the brethren. So, maybe brother, you are having some problems in your workplace. Maybe you want to quit or you want to go to other place. Or maybe you don't have a job. Maybe you are looking for a job. You try to apply different to your position, or you try to submit your CV, resume to the companies. But you're waiting for a reply, yeah. But there's no reply. Yeah. Maybe you are ill right now. You're suffering physically. I don't know what sickness you have right now, or whatever reason, or whatever illness you're having now. They are struggling with these illnesses. Pray to the Lord. Maybe you're a single person and it's waiting for Mr. or Mrs. Israel. I don't know. Or maybe you are waiting, you are a spouse, or you are a child, or you are a husband or a wife, that you are praying that your partner will be able to come to the wisdom and knowledge of the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe all the things that I mentioned to you, brothers, you are praying for them. I don't know what is really the point right now, but I don't know what are your heart's desire right now. Only God knows what is deep down inside your heart. So whatever, all these cases that you are having right now, don't forget to pray. Submit to His will. Pray more. Trust Him with all your heart. And God promises us that He will, to those persons who wait for Him, who wait for the Lord, God promises them that they will renew your strength. The last verse that I will share with you is Psalms 27:14. I will close for this. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and He shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say unto the Lord. Thank you. Salamat sa ito. Ay, may natutunan kayo ngayon.
Amen.
I-recite natin uli yung verse na yun. They that wait upon the Lord shall what? Renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And we praise the Lord that brother Ayon did not faint. There may study in that. Kung kinakabahan ka before the preaching, you would put up chapter 4 hours of preaching. So sister like, we can be after 4 hours. Yun yung aftermath niya. But that was a blessing. That was a blessing. Amen?
Amen.
That was a blessing. And next time it's easier, a lot easier. But trust the Lord as much as you need this time. Kasi minsan kung nasasalita tayo ng salita, we tend to rely more on our experience rather than resting or relying upon the power of the Lord. So that was a blessing. Were you blessed today? Amen?
Amen.
It's a blessing to see so many people in church today. And Brother Theodore, he is a member of Ebenezer Baptist Church in Cameroon.
Amen.
Talagang desire na rin na maghahanap. This is desire to find a church here. Yung kasi sinabi niya, parang he can't believe that there is a Baptist Church in our country such as this. But we praise the Lord also that He is with us. Amen?
Amen.
We would like to welcome Him in the family. Shall we all stand? Shall we all stand? And I do not know kung sino ang susunod na may need, but Brother Kenneth will come and lead us a song in a while, and we will pass our offering. This will be our help the needy offering. This week I was praying because I want to give for the kids ministry. Kasi medyo matagal na hindi ako nang pag-aid for the kids, and somebody has a need. Meron siyang, I know he needs 500 reals. Another member in the church I know needs some help. And so I was praying that the Lord will provide. And you know what? The Lord is good. Somebody gave me 600 and somebody gave me 200. Suggesting us to talagang binigay ng Panginoon out there to give to those who are in need. And I really praise and thank the Lord for that. Di ba na-mention kanina sa praises and thanksgiving. But I'm thankful to the Lord for providing for our needs. Amen? And again, always remember the reason why God gave us a job. Tatlong letter S, God provided us a job so that we can supply the need of our family, so that we can support the work of the Lord, and so that we can share to those who are in need. Brother Rod, you come and lead us in prayer. Okay? Brother Rod, will you please come?
Let me ask everyone to please bow your head, close your eyes, and Brother Ron will lead us in a prayer, and then Brother Kenneth will lead us a song when we are taking our offerings.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, once again, we give you thanks for this opportunity that we'll be able to give our brethren who are in need. Ano po magamit niyo po? Tama. We also thank you, Lord, for the these blessings you're giving us, and the health, the strength, the job you've entrusted to us. And we give you a double the present for you, for Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let me put some.
To get the glory, to get the glory.
God be the glory. We'll sing the first and last stanza.
Amen. 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 Amen I recommend to take turns of preaching some Friday mornings. And if you preach in the morning, I'll preach in the afternoon. If you preach in the afternoon, I'll preach in the morning. But next Friday, I'll be definitely speaking some afternoon. So ipapray natin yun. Ipapray natin ang ating mga men that the Lord will use them. Amen?
Amen.
And of course, ang mga ladies did, but especially the men na may-expose sila sa ganito, preaching, and when you go home to the Philippines, who knows? God will use you to start a church. You never know. You never know. And so ipapray natin yun. Brother Ron, will you please come and lead us in close word of prayer after the service. Make sure you get to know Brother Theodore. And make him feel welcome into the church. I also pray for Charles and James. So we are working on the papers now to go to the Philippines. They will take some units at Bethany colleges. Okay, that's a bit secular na mga courses offered on. Just a few units so that they can take a student visa. But they will be stay at La Loma and study at La Loma. You will stay there for 10 years, right? Vacation is not allowed. No vacation in 10 years. And by the time you go back to Africa, you're fine. Ipapray natin sila. Amen?
Amen.
Ipapray natin. And they will be trained. And after that, they will be sent back to the country to start churches. So, malaki pong vision ng very advanced church. The world is our field. We want to reach the world. So do pray for that. We already have to confirm James and Charles na pupunta sa Philippines. So we are working on the papers now. Tulungan natin sa pag-prayon that mag-materialize yung mga desires na ganyan. Okay, ingat kayo sa pag-drive at sa pag-uwi. And also, Brother Noel, para yung sa Alcor, Brother Joseph, will you approach here? Oh, magsisimula tayo. He approached me earlier. Nalipat siya from industrial sa somewhere doon sa Alco. Oh, yung sa Bible study ni Brother Roman yun, sa step 40. So, gumiwalag sila. So, dapat siya rin pumunta doon, di ba? Kasi nakatawag niya yun. So, do pray that we will be able to start several Bible studies again. Brother Allen, yung rin sa iyo natin ba? Kumusta? Tuloy mo rin yung talagang instead?
Kasi, nag-text ako sa kanila.
Punta natin sa Wednesday sa Mount Sinai. Mag-assign muna siguro ako doon sa 46 kung may pupunta doon. Samahan kita muna sa para malipay mo natin lang. Okay, so pray for the ministry again this week. Amen?
Amen.
Pray for the ministry that more Bible studies will be started, more workers will volunteer, and more souls that will be saved this week. Brother Rolo, pray.
Pray,
pray,
pray. Kamabalal ng mga pangyarihan sa lahat. Muli po kami, Panginoon, ay nagpapasalamat po kami sa biyaya po na pinagkalog niyo po na kami po yung mga pakinig po na yung salita po yung sa kanina po umaga at sa kapukod po po. Lord God, tunay nga po na kami po salita po ang magbabago sa tulungan niyo rin po kami sa iyong biyaya, Panginoon, na maipamuhay po namin, may apply po ang mga istas at karoban niyo po sa Panginoon Diyos, bawat isa sa pag-uwit na pagkaroon po ang action po at pag-iingat. At yan din po, Panginoon, sa nagpapagpang oras sa mga Bible school, ngayon po nawa ang patuloy na magkabay po sa bawat isa po sa amin. Panginoon, ipagkaroon din po ang kagalakan ng bawat isa po na nagpapatuloy po sa mga babae ng Panginoon. Ito po kami sa dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus.
Amen. Amen.